Hi, my name is Matt Schultz, and I'm a multimedia artist and college professor of art and design. Like many of you, I've been delving into AI art. Oh, I know, I just heard that trigger a whole lot of people, right? I have a philosophy, and I believe that everything you do is art. And if you're enjoying yourself, more power to you. So that kind of negates the entire argument. Who cares? Is photography an art, just pushing a button on a camera? Well, I'm sure some a long time ago said that to a photographer. There's a lot that goes into it. And if you choose not to put a lot into it and you just want to prompt stuff and have fun, again, more power to you. Why are we arguing? Everybody should be having fun. It's absurd. With that said, here's a stupid prompt. I like to prompt numbers. I prompted 8. I got this picture of this pretty woman. There you go. That's kind of half the fun with AI. The other half is doing all the work to come up with an image you want, and ideally to come up with an image you want that can be printed. All right, so what I'm going to do today is I'm going to go tap into some of my Photoshop courses that I teach, entire semesters just on Photoshop alone. And I'm going to explain what resolution is and then how to print your images and have them come out beautiful. And I'll show you an image I printed. So here we go. We're in Midjourney and the Discord Midjourney bot. I'm private because if you want to have a real discussion about art, is that all the people that are super lazy steal your stuff and then repost it on Facebook groups claiming it to be their own. That's the arguments we should be having and the discourse we should be talking about, as opposed to whether AI is art or not. With that said, here's my prompt. It's number 8. And if I click it, I can it'll give me the large version. And you click and hold, and let's drag that onto the desktop, and then we'll get rid of Discord. If I click and open this up in Photoshop, there we go. We're going to open that up right away. Command-0, show all. There it is. We got this photo. Midjourney is creating via the Discord servers PNG, which is a compressed file format system, just like JPEG or anything. It would be nice if they stopped doing that and somehow created a uncompressed formatting system. That would be great. Anyway, we have basically what is technically called in the print business a low-res photograph. How do I know? There's a couple of things. Without Photoshop, if you click on this, you can go in here and do Command-I on a Macintosh. Shows you the information or metadata of this file. And if you look, this is a 1024 pixel by 1024 pixel square image. Okay. If I go into Photoshop and I go to image size, although it says it's 14 inches and I'm rounding, 14 inches at 72 DPI, we can actually go and look at the pixels, and there it is again, 1024 by 1024 at 72 DPI. Now, oddly enough, the size is not as important as the resolution here, and this is a free college course for you people. This is extremely important. The resolution is very important. Low res or web graphics are 72 DPI, mid res is 150, and high res is 300 DPI or PPI, pixels per inch or dots per inch. If I wanted to make this a high res photograph without upsampling it, I would uncheck the resample and change it to 300. Every image that comes across my desk as a professional graphic designer and photographer who specializes in print format, magazines, things like this, I will do this in order to see what the best quality image is via Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop at 300 DPI. So what this tells me is this. This image will look ideally the best at 3 by 4 inches at 300 DPI. If I tried to upsample this photograph, let's go back. Remember, at 72 DPI, whoops, at 72, it was 14 inches, and I want to resample this into like a poster. I want to come up with a 36 by 24 inch poster, right? I'm upsampling by going up to 300 straight away, and it gives you a preview, and it says it's at 100%. You can see that down here. What I do know is that this is pretty much bad. It's a bad image. you may enjoy it. You could go to print with this stuff. It would work. But if somebody really walked up to this image of art that you created with Midjourney, it would look kind of bad. It would look cheap. It would look blurry, right? And sometimes you get what we call artifacting or aliasing on a line, an edge, where you see the janky pixels, right? Now, Photoshop has done its best to come up with algorithms to solve this upsampling issue, and it has bicubic smoother or preserve details enlargement, and that's what I'm using, because this offers this noise reducer, and really what it is just applying a soft blur to it so you don't notice. But is it making a crystal clear image? No, it's not. If I were to upsample this even larger, let's say to 36 inches, you can see, let's let it run, it's fuzzy and it looks terrible. Okay, so I'm going to actually leave this at 36. We're going to say okay. There you can see Photoshop. This is the algorithm of Photoshop, antiquated AI, right? Whatever it is, Photoshop is trying to fill in all the pixels that I have upsampled here. And now this is how big in my preview, this is how big this looks. And if I look at it, you know, this is really, at so many levels, it's just a bad, bad photograph. Okay. So you, like I said, a lot of these, you can go ahead and print this stuff, but it's just not the best way to do this. The best way to do it is to go, and I should get a free subscription to these guys, is to buy Topaz Gigapixel AI, right? I've already uploaded this image in here. I want to do this. This is six times the upsizing, upsampling for this image. You can see the original down here at the bottom. It says 1024 by 1024. And then this is times six is 6144 by 6144. So this is actually taking all those pixels, moving them apart six times from their normal space, and then filling in the data of all the pixels. And there it is. The render window's done. You can tell up here it says updated. If I touch this with my mover hand or space bar, it'll actually have to re-render it. But you can see here, the clarity of this image is amazing. So I cannot tell you, as somebody with 25 years Photoshop experience and graphic design experience, art director of major magazines and stuff, Gigapixel AI is it. And this is also it too. You can use the AI, which is this here. It's like interpreting itself, like, or the AI is doing the work for you, or you could turn it off and go and move stuff around manually, right? And I've played with this for a little while. I'm by no means a pro yet. You know what I mean? I've just gotten it a few months ago and I've been playing with it. And to be honest, I honestly think that the AI is just let it do its thing. Same with face recoveries, just leave it on and let it pick where it is. I put it midway to start with, right? So again, if we look at these two, right, here's six times, the preview window is a little smaller, but it is considerably more clear than what Photoshop can do, okay? Here's another thing is we're gonna save this. So the first thing I would do is to upsample it with Gigapixel, Topaz Gigapixel, and then it gives you the compression formats. I want to compress this as least as possible, and of these JPEG, PNG, and stuff, TIFF is the least compressor. Ideally, it'd be nice if it even allowed me to choose which compression method TIFF used, but we're gonna use TIFF because I believe from the print world, that has the least amount of compression. It's better than JPEG and PNG. So we're gonna save this to the desktop and then it's going to process this out, and this is the processing time. So I'm gonna let this process itself out and I'm gonna show you another example. And we'll put that down there. Now, here we are, a client had sent me this image because they wanted a picture, a poster made. And let's go ahead and open it up. It's of this woman. You can tell it's a Midjourney creation because she has 10 fingers on one hand, two hands, this hand's over here, it's all distorted. You could crop this out. And I can get to that later too. It's just we color correct this in Photoshop. I find that Midjourney is muted. The vividness is never as good as it could be. But let's go ahead and look at where we're at. This is image size. This was, again, like the other one, 14 by 21. It's a little higher because I did 9 by 16 allocation. So dash dash AR space 9 9:16, so it's doing the ratios, 9:16, better for portraiture, gets me closer to that poster size, right? And then I ran it through a gigapixel, okay? And I'm gonna go ahead and open up the TIFF here, and there it is. And if we go back and look at it, now this is the size of the photograph. You can see the clarity of the image here. She's 20:30 at 300 DPI. That's where I wanna be here. And the clarity is outrageous, man, just beautiful. Here, now I could use Photoshop and still go up a little bit. So I'm gonna move this up to 36. So there it is, it's 36:24. Let's pull it down. You can see that the preview enlarged it, but the clarity, her eyes look fantastic, right? And I might even pull the noise reduction back to just see, yeah, I would do it without the noise reduction. So here we go. We have a 36:24 image at 300 DPI. That's where we want to be. And this is where we get into the fine art of this, where it does become more like photography. And, you know, again, people are arguing it's not art. I've already color corrected this image, but that's a big thing, is just to come in and then be able to color correct these in Photoshop. So I upscaled it in Topaz Gigapixel, right? Then I brought that into here. A lot of times what I would do is just convert this to a smart object. And then I would go to Camera Raw. It's taking a little time because I got so much stuff running. And then this is great because, again, I can adjust how I want the shadows to appear. Let's do that. Saturation, and maybe it's too saturated. I want to pull it back. Maybe I want it super saturated. So again, all sorts of stuff. My black point, I could have it, you know, the background, the black be more rich blacks. I could increase my contrast. There's all sorts of things you can do here. Right. So again, we'll save that thing out, and then we would export that as, you know, I would keep this as a TIFF, but I would export that then as a JPEG, because what we're going to do is go to some of these companies. Right. And so if you type in digital canvas prints, you'll come up with some. I've used Vista Print is very good. Easy Canvas Prints is great. Very, very reasonable. And here I'll click on that. And here it is. You can create your own image, right? So, you know, whether I want that horizontal or what, let me get rid of that pop-up window. And here it is, a 24:36 is $33. How dirt cheap is that? And it's mounted, the canvas is wrapped around a wooden frame, just like a painting. So you can have it framed really nice too. Now, it's not 33, it's probably, depending on your expedited shipping, it's about $70 to $100, depending on how fast you want it. If you're willing to wait 2 weeks, it's like $50, right? So this is really, really worth it. I mean, it's unbelievable. And then what I'm gonna do is cut to a different video here and show you what the actual printed version looks like. Okay, and here we go. Here's the final image. Again, like I said, this canvas is wrapped around a wood frame, so it's very much like a painting. Very easy to buy a frame. This is 36:24. You can just go find, buy a frame for another, like, black, you know, nice frame for another $60. You're good to go. And the light switch, this is a wall. The light switch is there to show you the scaling. And then I just, you know, walk up to this. And again, there's a little bit of lamination that they offer for this that gives it longevity, because again, digital prints, if we went archival, it'd be a different story. That's only reflective because of the angle I'm at, right? So this is not actually there. It's actually really good. And if we go in, and there we go, I'm gonna stop there. You can see then, if you remember the image as we had from Gigapixel and Photoshop, at the end, the quality is just amazing, you know, and the canvas texture is nice. It gives it that little bit, looks like a painting. I think this is phenomenal. I don't see any reason why you can't take that, what is quote unquote, the low res image of Midjourney and go straight to Gigapixel and then upsample it there. Even if you can't afford Photoshop or don't have it, you could just go straight to that printer that I showed you, or any one of them too. I just think it's phenomenal. So again, I appreciate your time. If you want to follow me, I'm on Facebook or Instagram as Matt Schultz Artist. And you can go to my website, mattschultz.com. Thanks for your time. Have a good day.